Okay, and there is my design Kopan new glass, and there is even this tinting in this upper area. This is nice, because now there is it takes sun shining away, and then when we look in this down area, there we can see that there is Saint Gobain stamp in here, in that area. Saint Gobain is the maker of that. Okay, and now this is like new glass, and it is waiting for this installation. And then, of course, I like to show you that how I try to install that new glass. And remember that I am not professional in this windshield installation, and this is like my first installation. And please remember that let's look at what happens in this my glass. Is this still okay later this glass? Okay, good. And then we continue. Okay, and first step was that I need to take this bonnet out, and I open these bolts in here, and then there is also similar bolts in here, and I open also those, and then I can lift that bonnet out. Okay, and I work a little bit, and I open these bolts, and then I lift up this bonnet away. Okay, and these windshield wiper arms, they are easy to open when we have screwdriver, and when I insert that in just in this side in here, and I lift up carefully this cover, and there is this bolt, and this. Okay, now I drop it, I need to take it. But there is this cover, and in same idea, when there is this next one in here. Now I am more accurate, that I insert in here this my tool. And then, now it's in here, that this kind of part. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and then I need to open this wiper arms, this locking bolt, and for that job I need 14 millimeter socket, like 1-4 millimeter, and it fits in here, and then a little bit longer bar, and then I rotate that, and now this bolt opens. And there is this is specific bolt, Toyota's bolt. And then same idea in this next bolt in there. Insert my tool in here. And only a little bit rotation. And it opens. Good. There's bolt. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and then I need to take these wiper arms away. And now this arm opens easily. This nice, and then it is good to make in this wiper arms central nut, what is in there, it is good to make in their small sign and mark. I have in here pencil, and I insert in here this line that I remember that in what way this arm goes, because this is difficult. Now there is line. Now it's in this position, and there's also, now I remember that in this way this arm became back. And same in that bolt in there, also in here line, and in that area. And now I remember that this was this. Okay, cool. And then my plan is to take this wiper arm away, and it happens so that I take contact in here, and then a little bit movement and pull out, and now arm is free. And then let's look that how happens this next one. I take also my And in here, and then. No, and this opens also. Very well. So easy. Okay, and then remember also that if you have two arms, please make those text that this is like this driver side and this is passenger side. Because sometimes if we install those wiper arms in wrong position, then we have issues. But I remember that I have now this longer wiper in this driver area. And this is easy car. And then we continue. Okay, and next part is to take out this cover in here. And there are more small fasteners in here. When we look that area in there, there are small fasteners in here. It looks like that. And when I insert my screwdriver in here and I lift up, I maybe can open. Yeah, now it opens. Then I can carefully lift up. And if these parts goes broken, please go to visit in Toyota Dealership Center and we can purchase new one about $1 per piece. Now this this cover moves better, and I can check that there is the next bolt. Okay, and then this cover opens so that I need to only lift up that in here. And also here, and then carefully, then I pull out that cover. It is in there. Cover is in there. And now this is free in that area. There is my cover. Looks like that. And there is this another side. Okay, good. Then we continue. Okay, and then there is this panel in here, and in that part we can take away so that I only little bit bend that in this way, and then I only move that away in here, look, in that way, carefully. And now it opens. We can take this carefully out. And there is that kind of this locking system. Okay, good. And then we continue. Okay, and now this windshield is in quite free. There is this glass area in here. And we have only one this side panel in here up this area. But we can leave that part in this position. And we can start to take this glass away. And now there's idea that if I am glass windshield glass specialist, I have specific this cutting knife what goes in here down area. But now because I am not, I need to little bit move that up, and then I need in that position I need to use this protective glasses, because when I lift that up, this glass can go broken, and that's I insert my hand in here and I check that in what position, and then use also gloves, and then I check that in what position we have this side, because I am starting to open that, and in that position in here, and now I need to add in here some cutting knife in this inside area. And let's look at how it works. And I start this my job in this basic knife, and I insert that in here, and now I am planning to take this this old tools away. And let's look at how it happens, because it is in there. And now I am trying to insert this knife in here that I can see that in there, because then I can take this glue out in this lower area first in that area. And let's look at how my work continues. Okay, and now I also recommend that at least now I need to take this car's battery's minus cable away, because there is small risk that when I hit this windshield, like in that way, that this my airbag can explode in here. Airbag explosion and airbag bang, and that's it is good to disarm this airbag system. And please take this minus battery cable away. Okay, and now when I am doing this first scratch in here, I a little bit bent that my knife, and in same time this glass goes a little bit broken. And now I think that I can use my tongs. I use my tongs a little bit, that I can open. I use this my tongs that I can take this contact point in here. And now this glass goes broken, because I take in here and carefully I broken that little bit. And then we need to take this all this glass away. And now I take a little bit this paper in here that I can collect all small particle, glass particles away. Okay, now I am working in here, and I am now searching this glue area, because this is, and I little bit broke that my glass in here, in that area, and then I insert all of this my dirties in trash box in that way. Let's look at where is my glue area. I am now finding this glue. And then use these protective glasses, because small glass particles are flying. Now I think that in this area in here, there could be something glue in there. That side. And yes, there is. Now I go deeper. Okay, and then I take my knife. Before that, I insert this glass particles in glass. Good, and now I think that now I use my knife. Okay, and here was this really glue in that area. Okay, glue was in here, yes. Now we are in this glue line. In that position. And we check, and now this my knife. Now it is inside. Okay, and now I found this glue. And then I can start to move it like nice and carefully that way and also that way. And I can take this fold and be carefully move this knife always outside in your body, and because this knife is dangerous work, and also I have to be carefully with this glass size and sharp corners. And I don't have this. And then I do so that I move this my knife indirectly in there, in that area, in here, and then I continue my job that I move that my knife in this upper area in here, and then we continue. And I work a little bit in here. Okay, and now I notice that this glue is so durable in here that I have difficulties to cut that, and that's I take small crowbar and I carefully move that crowbar in that way, and now this my glass repair became quite messy because there is a lot of this small glass particles, but I will clean all of this part in my vacuum cleaner. But now I continue with that way, that I carefully broke this in the glass. Okay, and this open also in that way, but this is not the best way. But let's look that how this might work. Continue, but this is bad thing is that now there is quite much this small glass what I need to vacuum cleaning, and I need to collect all of these small particles away. Okay, but now I like to test that, and that's this knife what we use when we open this glue. It is really useful. But now I don't have that, and let's look at how I manage to take that glass now away. And I continue. Okay, and now I am working in there. Okay, now I am working in there, and I use these tongs. And I take this glass away that way, and this part I can take this away easily that way, and then I only collect this glass particles away, and then I like to open it more. I go forward that way. Very cool. Then in that another way. There. I have to say this is not the right professional way, but this is like handyman's way that how to take this glass away. And now I work, and let's look that how soon I can take this glass away. Okay, and at that point it's good to check that where is this glue. And now there is there is first gasket what goes in this dashboard. And then this glue area, it is in. And I move. And then I go in here. This glue is in this lower area in here. In that area. It is good to check. This area is glue, what we need to install finally. And it is glue area. And then I open that, and this chop goes quite fast. Only that I have quite much to clean. There is this my tongs. Okay, and these glass particles really flies away, that do not work in outside, because then your ground is full of glass particles. And look in that my area. In there we can see that there are these small glass particles in this ground. But I will clean all of those parts away. And this is not. And also in inside area, when we look in there, there are now some glass particles in inside that I need to also clean this inner area, because there is some glass particles in there. Okay, but let's look. I believe that this became good result and excellent experience, that how handyman can replace this windshield glass without special tools. And this is the result. But then I continue. Okay, and then I decided to take a little bit this glass particles away using this my vacuum cleaner. And then I have in here this heat gun, and I think that if I a little bit heat up this my glass, maybe this glass opens easily. And let's see that what happens. Then I have a little bit heat up that can I take this. Can I open this easily? When I heat up this my glass, how it opens when I believe that this heat will help. And then I think that at least, yes, something opens easily. Okay, and then I think that I clean also this inner area in this my car. I insert this my cleaner. I continue. Okay, and now I am in this position, and in all time it's good to clean and take those glass particles away in all areas. Okay, and all time cleaning. Okay, and then I continue my job. Okay, and then I am working in that corner, that we can see that how I am going in here. I have this crowbar tool, and in that area I am moving my tool in here in this way. I am going forward. Okay. And I have to be carefully that I don't damage this car paint. Because it is a bad thing. And then I insert this my crowbar in that side in here and then a little bit I paint that more. And this glass opens. I can go forward. First is my working position. And here I insert my tool in that way. And go, and I go inch by inch forward. This is like drilling, mining. But really messy job. Okay. And I have to be also carefully that I don't damage this inner panels also, because it's bad. And then I continue my job in forward. And soon we can see more. Okay, and then when we work, it is important to check all time that what is this distance in here, this gap, when we are installing new this glass, that we remember that how big is this gap in here. Because now when I am taking that glass away, this gap is actually, it is that line in here, yes, in this gasket in here. Okay, good. And then we can continue. Okay, and now I have worked in here so much that almost all areas are free. And I can even, when I insert my hand in here, I can move this glass, only this outer, this top area in there. Here we have this glass glue still left, and then we can go to look that other side, this area in here, that what is there happening. And there is a situation that when I have take that glass, the glass moves quite nicely, and then I planned that I go in that position and I lift that full glass away in this position in here, in that way. And then I can take this full glass away next. And let's look at how it happens. Okay, and now I am lifting this upper area in here. And I go in here inside in this car. And then I move that, because here we have this one gasket in this area and this sealant, and that I lift it up, and then I move that glass, and now this glass goes, it moves, and it goes away. Okay. Soon I can take this full glass away and then we can look this result next. Okay, and then I have installed in there this paper, these rolls. And then when I move that my glass, this is almost free. And with that, carefully, when I move that away, I have to be carefully, this class is quite soon away, and it looks like that. Okay, and soon when I can take that out, we can look my results, and I have quite much this glass in here that I need to clean all of these areas, like in here. And this is not so easy job to do, but let's continue. Okay, and there this glass is finally. It is in here, and now I have took that away, and there is also bonnet. And then when we look in that area, we can see that window is away, and then I have quite much to then when I have vacuum clean all of these things, we can continue. Okay, and next step when I have take these dirties away is to take knife, and I need to take all of these glass particles away in this old glue. And there is idea that I need to left this old glue about 2 millimeters in here. Quite thin amount in here, this old glue. And like in here, I take that old stuff away, and something like 2 millimeter what we left in here, this old glue in here. And then I go through this my window, and when I have take all of these glass particles away, we can continue. Okay, and then I am taking out this glass part, what looks like that. And I have this sharp mattress knife, what works really well. And then look in here, in that position. Sorry, we look that area, there is my knife, and I insert that in just in here. This is really interesting. And then I carefully move that, and I cut this old glue in that way. Be carefully in here, and there is one slot, and again I go in here a little bit that area in there. I take a little bit better view. And in that way, this area became better and better. And there is one part left in here. And be carefully with this knife. And I insert my knife in here and then I cut just in here. And this knife cuts this nicely. Okay, good. And now this my job is, it works forward. Okay, and now I have removed all glass particles and also this area. These areas are clean. And next I can start to install my something pre liquid in there, and then we can continue. Okay, and then I have purchased this specific this Sikatak drive windscreen replacement kit. And what I have in there, I have first in there, and I take that my thing, there is this paper, and then there is this activator pro, this activates this my glue, and there is then this primer that I can clean rusty things. And there is some other stuff, and there is this specific this Sikatak drive this glue for this windshield installation. Okay, and then there is this very good instructions, and let's go to look those closer that we can see that what I am planning to do next. And this first step was that I need to take these panels away, and then there is that I need to remove this windscreen, and there is that take windscreen out, and then there is that kind of that I need to install some tape in there. Okay, and then I need to wash that I need to wash my windscreen, and there is something that Sika clean glass that I need to wash this my windscreen, and then there is this next thing that I need to install this activator. There is Sika Activator Pro, and it is that stuff in here what I need to install in my glass, and then I need to cut this my old this glue 1 to 2 millimeter deep, and then I need to add in there this activator also, Sika Activator Pro, in these areas also. Okay, and then I need to add this primer in here. This is primer and small pencil, primer pencil, and then I need to open this my glue, and then I need to install this glue, and I install this glue in this my glass, and also this body, car body, and then I need to lift this glass in there, and final those side list in there, and then I need to wait something like 2 hours that I can dry. Okay, and then I continue so that I start to clean this my windshield glass, and I will do that next. And then I take this my activator, and I install that activator in this my glass. Okay, and I will do that next. And then I use this my activator in this areas in here. Then I clean these side areas, that they are all clean. they must be clean. And then I go through. I have cleaned these areas, we continue. Okay, and then I take this my Premiere, actually this Premiere, and I install that. This is like paint in this area, and I go to install that next. And this primer, it is like protector that there is no any rust. I install that in here, in that side. This is like against corrosion. Okay, and I go through these areas, and now when we install this primer, we don't install that primer in these glue areas, because otherwise there is difficulties in this glue work. Okay, and then I insert this Sika Drag Drive glue, and I have in here this opening tool, and it happens so that I insert that in here, and then I hit this in that way. Now it's open, and first I insert using that part, I insert this my glue in this car body area, and this is just specific suitable for this job, and I insert that my tool in here in that way, and then this hole in down, and then I little bit I compress, and then we go to look this car body area next. Okay, and then I start to install this my glue, and there is starting point, and idea is that when I insert that in here in that way, and now I remember that I need to insert this hole, look this hole in up, this is the idea. Now I do again, and about 1 centimeter glue. And that way good. And then I insert this glue in all areas in here. Okay, and then we continue. And I go through this all areas. Okay, and now I have inserted that glass in there back, and then I press this is my glass that it goes deeper in here. All areas they are deeper. Okay, and now this glass is ready for next step. And then I inserted also these tapes that will keep this in position. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and then I install this side list that are in here, this side list, and I check that are they in okay, they looks fine, and I start this installation here up, this up position.
then I moved it. I hammer it.
Okay, now side list out there. Okay, good. And this looks quite okay. And then I continue. Okay, and then this my windshield replace is done, and I have finally this windshield in place, and I managed to install this windshield quite okay, because now I have tested that is this windshield in very tight in this position, and it is really tight, and then I made about 100 miles testing road in highway, and I drive with this quite high speeds like 80 miles per hour, what is like 130 kilometers per hour, and there was no any issues in there. And then I am very happy that this windshield is okay and there is no any cracks. And I managed to install this windshield so that there is no any holes or cracks. And actually this windshield is just perfect condition, like 100% okay. But of course this windshield replace, it was really, really big and difficult job. And it takes my time about 6 hours, and it is long period. And next time I think that I replace that my car's windshield in some specialist who is professional in this windshield area, because this is so difficult and time consuming job. But now I have tested that, and then we can go to look at my windshield closer. Okay, and there when we look at windshield, it is well in place. And all these panels are fine. And this list also, I also reuse this list, and this looks good, and also these panels, they went in this position very easily, and they are in nice. Okay, and then it is of course good to test that when I open this my car's door, that when I insert my hand in there inside, that how tight is this my glass. When I lift that my hand up, now I think that this is really tight, that there is no any issues, and everything looks okay. Okay, and then I have final job to do. And this job is that when there was so much this glass when I replace, and now I need to clean my garage floor because there was so much small glass things in my floor. Okay, but there is my next tool what I start to use next. Okay, and then thank you for watching that video and have a nice day to you.